We've seen a lot of tragedy this year, which is heartbreaking.
For firefighters and paramedics, coronavirus presents a new risk to an already risk-filled job. And as the COVID death toll continues to rise, one recent death, that of Exonia EMS Captain Kelly Rather, has hit first responders especially hard.
Myself and my other partner, we were okay, and she was the one that ended up testing positive.
The 42-year-old Rather transported a patient who tested positive for COVID the following day. Rather died of the virus on Thanksgiving. Wauwatosa EMS Division Chief Chris Sandoval says Rather's death shows how dangerous the situation can be on the front lines.
How does that hit a department like this?
It's tragic. It's very tragic. All of our members reviewed that case and understand that there are very real dangers to what we do.
I'm not going to lie to you and say it's scary.
Madison Fire Lieutenant Malin Mitchell heads the state firefighters union.
You know, as firefighters and paramedics, we are an integral part of the entire healthcare system, right? We get there first.
Something else to consider is that the danger that first responders face from COVID doesn't just impact them. It could put anyone in the community at risk.
Positive COVID cases, even among families and communities, can sideline first responders. Mitchell says that as many as 25% of his union's members have contracted the virus or have been in quarantine at some point during the pandemic.
And we've had, you know, 6 to 10 on quarantine at one time, that's 14 days. If we can't get anybody to come in and backfill, you're then talking about browning out of stations or closing down rigs that respond to our community.
In Milwaukee, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.
The International Association of Firefighters reports 21 of its members across the country have died after contracting COVID-19 in the line of duty.
The New York Times broke the story tonight about COVID vaccine maker Pfizer offering